the disciple out here with him, and you know,
there was never any question about that.
Never any question about that, and never any question that if the heat gets too intense, the disciple will be a part of this. We understand the Macho Man's entrance when we come back live on TNT. The disciple's got Nick.
No disqualification.
Yeah, but there's no referee now. Reverse neckbreaker. Oh. And now that opens up the floodgates for Hogan and the disciple. Nick Patrick is out cold.
Don't look good.
What are we going to do here?
And the disciple is fresh. Look at the body on that man.
All right, Hogan's got a plan.
Make a wish.
Remember, there must be a winner. How in the world are we going to determine a winner here now? Oh, this is going to be it. They're out to end the career of Savage, and they may have done it right there. We talked about the ring post. We talked about how unforgiving that steel is, the most dangerous part of the ring area.
Well, it's steel. Steel don't bend, stupid.
And it's heavy steel.
And Nick Patrick, I guess, is still out.
Now out to end the career.
In professional wrestling.
I don't think he would, but he could give up. But there's no one to give up to.
He may have given up. I doubt it, though. You could pull his tongue out. He won't give up.
Hogan will pull Savage out to the center of the ring. Nick Patrick, as you can see, bottom of your screen, still face down. And here comes the disciple. He has the world title belt.
They're having their way with him right now.
Gentlemen, this has been all Hollywood Hogan. Savage has had some flurries because of his determination and his grit and his demeanor. He's gonna go!
The disciple hit the apocalypse right on the championship belt. Savage is out.
What is this?
Big Sexy
Nash.
Has seen enough.
Nash!
Kevin Nash comes out. Kevin Nash standing over Savage. Who is this behind him?
Uh-oh. Let's
he
just
said
watch
no run
this.
It. Remember, Piper said no
That's
run
Bischoff.
It.
Bischoff.
That's Bischoff. Piper said no one can run in for this match.
I think we're seeing the split right now.
Oh! Down goes the disciple.
Powerbomb on Hollywood.
Trying to get the jackknife. Those kicks from Bischoff.
Oh, Bischoff getting down.
Nash is determined. He's going to powerbomb Hollywood.
Here it comes!
Oh, I wanted to see this on my life.
Jackknife Hollywood!
Savage is going to win it.
He put Savage on Hogan.
Get Patrick up.
Here comes Bret Hart. Bret Hart with him.
Bischoff over.
I know.
I think it's Bischoff. with Rodzilla in the house, the disciple watching my back, the man with the brains and all the Uncle Teddy's money. There will be no stopping NWO Hollywood now, because brother, all you people, all you misguided souls with the red and black on, this is your chance to jump back across the track, Jack, because NWO is definitely for life.
We love you all, each and every one of you, even the ugly ones.
Now, say what you want to about them, they certainly have a major influence in the sports world. With you see him right there, a world champion in his own right, Dennis Rodman, returning back to the white and the black, along with world champion Hollywood Hogan.
How can we lose with the stuff we got to you? It's an all-out assault on the WCW, Kevin Nash, and his group of followers. I feel sorry for those dudes that made the wrong decision. Rodzilla, keep him alive.
It's all about it, baby. It's all about the NWO for life, baby. I started it last year. Hey, there's no turning back, baby. This is for life, baby. For life.
We be the founding fathers. Oh, yeah. We be the ones.
Nitro from the Palace of Auburn Hills is off and running. Great wrestling action tonight and more to come. Live.
Hey, yo. That's enough lying and denying, big man. Why don't you do us a favor, like you said earlier, pack your bags and walk on out.
Where's that coming from?
Outer space.
You and all your little followers out there, get out of Hollywood's house, because me and Rodzilla, we be taking over, bruh. Rodzilla, give him a little pyro, man.
Oh. Well, for, I guess, they have a skybox or something here?
Hey, Rodman can push a button.
Scream it to the heavens. Nobody wants to hear your bum copycat rap. Hey, I guess we know who wields the power now. Yo, NWO Rod, it's a little too bright in here. Shut those lights down. I can't stand looking at them. Oh. That's exactly how we like to see you. Not there and nowhere. Let's see the face. Back on, Rod. Yo, boys. I mean, girls. I guess you know who the man is now, don't you? The pecking order has been decided by all the NWOites. We're taking over the world. And I think Godzilla, we've seen enough of them. Now it's time. Let's get them off here. Let's cut to a commercial break, brother. Show them something they should be buying. This is what it's all about. NWO.
Promotional consideration paid
for
by the following.
Life.
I called my attorney, brother, and you, I like, hey, bite me, you know. I heard that, Rod. Wow, ouch.
Higher, higher.
Wow. Point taken. Kevin Nash, 25, 30 power bombs, 50 grand a pop. I called my attorney, Henry Holmes, the real NWO attorney. We're going to collect tonight, brother, and we're going to collect on you, Kevin Nash, because you owe me a lot of money.
Tell the good part.
Oh, the good part. Here's the good part, you know. Lawsuit. I like that. You know, let me tell him. Rodzilla, the big surprise. Somebody you haven't seen yet, brother, that's on the team. NWO Hollywood, the newest superstar to hit the big screen. The man who's going to rock the world, brother. Just wait till he sees him, Mr. Bitchoff.
Didn't you tell me, Hollywood, that he was going to be the second biggest name in Hollywood? Is that what you told me?
Second biggest, brother. And wait till they see Leah. They're going to just totally freak out.
Kevin Nash, you made your bed, and now you're going to live in it. And we'll be more than happy to live in ours. Hollywood, you are the man. Rodzilla, thanks for coming tonight. Thanks for bringing the talent.
Where'd you get the talent?
Come on, man. Look at this. Look at this. You gotta love this. This is life, right? For life, forever, baby.
Right here. You know, there are some things worth missing practice for, brother. And that's definitely the NWO, brother. I want to tell you something. You're going to be known as the man in the world of professional wrestling that made the biggest mistakes of his career. The second biggest mistake you made, brother, was stepping in the ring with the greatest there is, was, and will be against Hollywood and the Hitman. You take a partner like that low-life Roddy Piper, the second greatest mistake you ever made. The first greatest mistake you made was when you jumped ship a little too early and joined the red and black attack that we're going to knock back, Jack. Because the white and black, we just multiply, brother. And if you wonder why me and the Hitman don't have that bevy of beauties around us, there's a reason for that. What Hollywood Hogan giveth, Hollywood taketh away. And brother, we're going for the prime choice U.S. cut. That's why, come on in, baby doll. Miss Elizabeth, you know how to stick it to the macho man, but you also know how that Hollywood likes you. And macho, what you gonna do, brother, when Hollywood Hogan runs wild on what you used to have, bruh? Ooh, yeah, dig it, baby.
Can you believe what we've just seen?
We have just seen something very dangerous.
Well, you're not kidding.
That will push Savage farther off the edge than he's ever been.
The guy is nuts.
The most dangerous man probably walking here.
Tell me, is it Mr. Jekyll or Dr. Hyde tonight, huh?
Yeah.
Are you going to be this late for the tag team also, huh? Who do we have, Sybil Savage? Who do we have in the ring tonight, huh? Don't old man me. I gotta fight you too. Why I gotta fight you and a tag team on top of it, I don't know, but that's the way it's gonna go.
You obviously don't know me, do you?
What? Where do you want me to come there, champ?
Since this is Motown and it's Murder City, why don't we do it tonight?
No need to wait.
There'll be nothing left of them for the pay-per-view, though.
Girls, hey, girls. Hey, girls. Hey, girls with the kilt on, with a dress. Hey, macho girl. You know, Motown's a pretty heavy city. I don't know if we can handle a cat fight tonight with a couple sissies like you guys. But you know something? This is where the power lies, brother. And Macho Man, this is where it's going on. Way up here, brother. So just like I told you, Macho, and Sissy with a skirt on, Hollywood giveth and Hollywood taketh away. And seeing how Hollywood is in a giving mood, Mr. Eric Bischoff made all this happen. He's my guiding light. He's the source behind the force. And now I give you Mrs. Ooh, yeah.
Elizabeth. She's all yours, brother. Do what the Macho Man couldn't do.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, Macho, we don't need no Viagra up here, brother.
Oh. The Greco-Roman
lip lock. That's a deep, deep kiss, brother.
Yes.
Oh. Hey, Bret, look at the two sissies out there. Mercy, mercy, mercy. Elizabeth, Hollywood Hogan, let me tell you something that you both don't know. You couldn't get the job done. Tell us. Tell us you couldn't get the job done, Mr. Viagra.
Wow.
Ooh, yeah. It don't do it. Elizabeth, I got over you a long time ago. In Hollywood, Hogan, I will never get over you.
Oh, and they love it.
See, Bret Hart started all this.
He's the instigator.
Right, he started stirring the pot.
Just nailed Savage with a right hand.
They're going to go right now.
And look at that. The NWO Hollywood
look
faction.
At Liz. Look at Liz. Oh. In the time
mind
of her life.
Man. They're loving every minute of it.
And look at Savage. He's gone. He's gone.
Savage has got the steel chair. Monday Nitro rolls on from the Motor City. Yet to come, Goldberg defends the U.S. title, plus DDP's decision.
The man is here.
Here in the Motor City, even from you, Savage. You know, Nash, when you hopped off that black and white express and got away from Hollywood scum Hogan, you reminded me of the guy I used to go up and down the roads with. The guy who made me laugh had a big heart. And you showed that to me by taking K-Dog with you. Because he was your boy there, and he came with you. Bang. And then you let Hennigan and even Savage, four of the greatest athletes on the planet, I seen what you were doing. But man, when you got Lex Luger. That blew my mind. And when he brought Stinger in, well, if you want me now, man, makes me feel something right here. I can't believe I'm gonna do this. Man, there's nothing more important.
Ow!
Oh, my goodness.
That was Rodman. And Hogan.
Oh, they blindsided him good. Right from behind. Oh, listen to that.
Just when he was going to make that decision.
Oh, he's hurt. He just got back after getting those ribs. They were injured all that for 6-7 months or so. Now he's with 100% healthy. We thought, but look at him now.
We can see the concern of the other NWO Wolfpack members.
There was Rodman and Hogan, man. There was Rodman and Hogan.
Don't forget, Thunder, this Thursday.
Hey, wait a minute! He waffled him! He waffled him with a chair, and I think Benoit saw that.
Well, Booker T never saw it.
Yeah, the referee didn't either, but Benoit saw what happened.
He's counting. Two.
And I think Hart said, I did that for you. Cover him. Look at this. He's telling Benoit, cover the man. I did this for you.
He's at five now. He's at six. He's at seven. It'll be Finley and
right.
I don't think he's not going to. Hold on.
Benoit stopped the count. He stopped the count.
He told the referee. He said, I can't take that. And he's telling the referee that Bret Hart hit the man with a chair. What do we got here?
Patrick said disqualification.
Benoit, he's the winner.
We had seven of the greatest matches, you know, in my short career here in professional wrestling. And I want to tell Benoit, you're the best wrestler I've ever been in the ring with. I got more respect for you than I have for any man. So Benoit, J.J. Dillon, like I told you in the back, I don't want to win the match like that. I want this thing to go just one more time. Benoit, me and you, we want to settle this thing the right way.
How about that? One more time. It's what he wants.
Well, Booker, you understand that the referee rendered the correct decision. He started to count you out, and I have to say I have the utmost respect for Chris Benoit because he stopped the referee. It was obvious he didn't want to win it that way. And once he made the referee understand that there was outside interference, he did the correct thing, stopped the match and raised your hand.
That's right. You're a champ, baby. You're a champ.
But from what you've told me privately and what you're saying now, if I'm hearing you correctly, this is not how you want to win it. And I don't think that either of you justice is served if it concludes this way. So yes, I can do something about it. By order of the executive committee, I want you to come to Baltimore this Sunday to the Great American Bash pay-per-view. Go back in the ring one more time because I'm throwing out tonight's decision. Chris Benoit has agreed to come back. You will face each other for match number 7. The final deciding match will do it all over again. And whoever is the winner will get, as promised, the match for the title against Fit Finley at the Bash before it's concluded.
Ooh.
And I congratulate you. I have the utmost personal and professional respect
for
you.
Thank you very much, JJ.
Man, what are you doing?
This doesn't have anything to do with
it. Man, you're the champ.
Don't worry about it. I got
you. Man, this sucker don't want you to be the champ.
Man, I got it. Don't worry about it.
What are you doing, man?
It's the right thing to do.
All right. Well, Mike, back to you. The winner will have to wrestle twice.
Well, I think that's the way to set
opportunity to speak your mind. So Liz, take the microphone please and share with the people your thoughts on Randy Savage.
Well, you know, Randy Savage, you came out here Monday night and you told the world that you were over me, that you were over me. Well, once again, you've gotten those facts confused because I'm the one that left you. And I didn't have to get over you because the best thing about you's always been your checkbook, and I've already got that. You know, the whole world knows I've always been your crutch. Well, I know you hardly have a leg to stand on. It really doesn't matter what the world knows. It matters what I know and what you know. And what you know is, I'm the best thing that ever happened to you. I'm the reason you're Randy Savage. You know, it's time to move on. I have. And I'm not so sure you have. But wipe that heart off your sleeve. And when you do, wipe the slate clean and think about that Macho Man thing. You know, it's just, no, please.
Ugh. Go ahead and tell him. Go ahead and tell him. Who's the real Macho Man? Go ahead.
The real Macho Man, as everyone knows, our president.
Thank you all very much for yielding the floor to one of the most beautiful women that has ever graced this arena, or this industry, I might add. And Randy, well, eat your heart out, sucker. Go ahead and fight me.
Let's go.
Thank you all very much. We love you. We love each and every one of you. She loves you too.
So many backstabbing going on. When you got members of the NWO, different factions right in the midst of it, as we are in the tag team match here tonight, Brent. I know this has been a big night for you.
It's been an honor, really, to receive this award from Elio DePaolo and his family, and to be in the ring with Lou Fez and the likes of Billy Ray Lyons and all that. It's an honor. And I'll tell you something, I've never seen this much emotion, this much frustration, this much energy.
energy out of the disciple until now. He thinks he's going to be tag team champion of the world.
Giant made it abundantly clear that according to the Giant, when I win the tag, that is built up between these sides of the New World Order. Power struggle, yes. More than just that, though. Oh, my! The disciple was wiped out.
Hey, 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 hey! Macho, macho! To me, you want her? Come and get it! Come on, you chump!
He's baiting the Macho Man. He wants the Macho Man to come towards you.
Well, he's smarter than that.
And, of course, that... Bischoff! Bischoff the nut! He's gonna check.
You know, I've had to sit back and think about it. And I need somebody that's intense. I need somebody that's built hard as a rock.
I'm kind of busy.
I know you're busy. You know, I thought about you. But you know, you're running the NWO, and right now you're the first and the last name in wrestling. So I had to find another partner. Somebody that's got a devastating finish move. Susie grabs him and knocks him out cold. Something like an apocalypse. And there's only one person I can think of. Big D the Disciple!
Hey everybody, welcome the new World Tag Team Champions, the Disciple and the Giant, coming up this Sunday. Take a look at this.
Did I pick a partner? This guy is lean, mean, he's a killing machine. So anybody else who wants to step up and get a piece of us? Well, I tell you what, I'm already the World Tag Team Champion. They're my belts. Brutus, right here, my man, the Disciple, the big guy, he's my partner. You know what, Dallas? Lex, everybody else in the back, you guys want to run your mouth? You know what, Lex? An idea for you. Why don't you grab a partner? Grab anybody you want to. I don't care who it is. Grab anybody. I don't care. Disciple and I right here tonight, we'll cancel you like a bad check. Because what doesn't get chokeslammed, it's going to meet the apocalypse.
And one last thing before we get to the action here, before we join our party. Guys up at the... DDP, as Sting hovered over him right there, wiped out. Here comes wrestling fans around the world, unmistakable. That brings them to their feet here at the Nassau Coliseum.
And there's the world's heavyweight champion, Hollywood Hulk.
The Disciple, and they have something to tell us. Something, you know, they have come out here many times.
This they is the house that Hollywood built for us.
They have the title, they defaced the world title.
Disciple.
They always say something of major importance concerning the world of pro wrestling.
And you have to admit that last night at the Great American Bash, Hollywood Hogan and Bret the Hitman Hart were certainly a tag team united.
Hogan once again, as arrogant as always, on his way to tell the world another pack of lies.
I don't think there's any question the man lies. The man. Out of his mouth. But what this is about, I don't know. You can always get a feel for the number of lies, for
the garbage is going to fly out of his mouth by their demeanor as they walk through the entranceway.
Seem pretty confident tonight, don't they?
Yeah, they're giddy tonight is what they are.
Ace.
The unmistakable trademark of ripping the shirt off, and you can't deny the physique. One of the true trademarks in the wrestling profession for
Hollywood
decades.
Hollywood wanted me to tell you just how bad he's missed each and every one of you fine people. He loves you, he really does. And I know that you love him. How's it feel, Hollywood? We've been talking about this for months, man.
To all the NWOites that worship Hollywood Hogan, welcome back to the house that Hollywood built. And as the sign says, on the seventh day, God created Hollywood. Now that all the trash has been talked, I'm here to set the record straight. As far as Big Slimy goes, oh yes, there is a pecking order. As I was selling out Madison Square Garden, as the NWOites were ripping their t-shirts off, the Slimy one and all of his underlings were watching TV, praying that someday they could be just like me. And now that I always have been the world's heavyweight champion, everybody that worships me knows forever and a day, I will always be the man, brother. Now, as far as all the crybabies go in the red and black, Jack, and all the crybabies in the WCW go, the one that makes me the sickest of all is the one that I'd love to chop down and bury him 10 feet under. Diamond Dallas Page. If you got a problem with me and Dennis Rodman beating your brains out, I double, triple dog dare ya to step up to the plate and do something about it. And oh yeah, Mr. Bischoff, I've heard Bob Costas, all the rumors in the playoffs, as my man Dennis Rodman, Rodzilla, dogged every one of the Utah Jazz, especially their big man. And I knew Diamond Dallas Page was in Utah trying to get a cheap shot on Rodman, but he was too scared to make a move. So Diamond Dallas Page, beg whoever you want. The rumors are on the street. I dare you to find another coward to stand next to you, because me and Dennis Rodman are for real, brother. We've signed on the dotted line for Bash at the Beach, and I could think of nothing better for all my disciples out there that worship the ground that I walk on to watch Bash at the Beach, watch me and Rodzilla get in the ring and beat your brains out, Diamond Dallas Page, and the partner of your choice. Because Hollywood don't deal in partial posts. Hollywood deals in first-class delivery, brother. So bring it on. I'm the champion now. I'm the man now. And as far as all my NWOites, Hollywood will always be for life.
For Bash of the Beach coming up on July 12th in San Diego, and dare DDP to get a partner of his choice. He alluded the rumors we talked about earlier. Although nothing is yet official about Karl Malone, the fans, one thing that is official, two things actually, a steel cage, DDP, the Macho Man Randy Savage, and also the special referee Rowdy Roddy Piper. And who will stand under me?
Diamond Dallas Page to climb in the ring with me, the Disciple, and Rodzilla, and Bash at the Beach. I'll bury you and drag you all the way back to Venice Beach and put you to rest.
Page went up in the air, just a few steps. Did you notice that?
Got a about a foot or so, it looks like.
Oh, my goodness.
Hollywood Hogan.
And then that cage rising up and able to... There's the disciple.
There's the black and white. That's what that is.
They have all come out in the ring, and who's their target? Bret the Hitman Hart's out. Miss Elizabeth's out.
This was supposed to be Wolfpack versus WCW.
And the cage went back down. How did that happen?
Somebody's raising it, somebody's lowering it.
You're not kidding, someone's doing it. And the raising enabled the black and the white to get in there.
Grand Arena, the United Center, home of the Bulls, and as we know, home during most of the year to the Worm, Dennis Rodman. We can't help but think that not only is Dennis...
This afternoon, prior to Nitro coming on the air, and...
The disciple has come in! Into the gut! On the jawbreaker! And look, Hogan's got the attention of the referee! The referee did not see any of this! And he rolls Nash over!
And that man's here to help Hogan at any cost!
One, two! It's over! It's over! The three count! Say what you want to about non-trust, distrust, not getting along. Hogan and the NWO helped out Nash and Savage, their own members this time, guys. There's no question about that.
And as he promised, the disciple would be there to cover his back, and he certainly has as they double team on Piper.
Well, he's always been there. Get a look at this. The disciple drops Luger. It's like he broke his jaw. Takes Nash, rolls him over. Just gotta have a hand on his body. Sneaks out of the ring. Nash gets a 1-2-3 right here on Luger.
Fans, Piper and Hogan are scheduled to wrestle when we come back. We gotta break them up to get them back in the ring.
Him in the sleeper.
And the disciple comes in. Nick Patrick's seen enough. He's gonna throw it out, and he gets thrown out.